Hey folks, Kilt-Man here, Kilt-Man! At your service. If you've got one of these or something similar, raise it. Let's enjoy together. Cheers, y'all. Now, I've got a mask for you. I've already opened it, so it won't be a mystery unboxing or anything like that. I've got it. I've seen it. It's right there. And he likes it, or he does. I'm quite impressed with it. Now, here we go. I've shown you a few masks which have a similar sort of theme, like scarecrows or some kind of, you know, they've got some kind of burlap sack upon their face and it's kind of twisted. I've had a few of them lately. And this one joins the ranks because it's quite similar again. This is called Zipper Man or Zipper Mouth, depending on how it's advertised. And here he is. Look at this guy. Ooh, that's unusual, isn't it? Yeah. Proper zips, which genuinely work. I'll show you them in a minute. Whole lot of, you know, ghastly woundage taking place there. And some kind of steampunk effect going on with like a bit of a goggle type thing, one of which of course is split asunder, so your real eye can poke through, because that one has gauze behind there, so you'd be peering through a black gauze. Immediately, a lot of you are going to go, yeah, it's button face. No, it's not, because it's not. It's zipper face. But quite clearly, he's been modelled on the character that David Cronenberg plays in Clive Barker's Nightbreed, Dr. Deckard, who becomes button face in his spare time. A serial-killing, mask-wearing, deranged loon bag, which has a very, very similar look to this, except there's buttons here. But, you know, I like that look. I genuinely think it's very effective. Before any of you ask, I don't know who made this. I've got the label here, the tag, one of them big ass tags that sit on top of the head like that. And it says, adult carnival item, mask, one size fits all, special edition. Why is that special? And on the back, you don't have a maker's name at all. And he is called Zipper Man, or Zip Mouth Fancy Dress. But I'd seen him a few times and I thought, you know, I like that. I might get that one day. Today, apparently, is that day. But here he is now. Look at it. Now, apart from the button face reference, I've got no idea of the genesis of this particular, you know, person, creature, monster, whatever the hell he is, thing of nightmares. But as I said before, with some of these very tight sort of masks, they have a kind of horrible home invasion look about them, a purge look, and dare I say it, balaclava, you know, rapist kind of thing. And, you know, now I've got hold of it, that kind of, you know, vogue really does kind of hit home. And it is kind of scary and ghastly just for that alone. But the colouring is a kind of sort of sandy, yellowy, off-cream, sickly sort of colour. You have nostrils on display, which makes it kind of unusual again, in that, is this meant to be some kind of burlap? Because it doesn't have the texture. You know, it wouldn't, it's latex, but the texture could be sculpted in. It does not have that kind of, you know, burlap feel and look to it. But is it skin? Because it's got these zippers stitched in. It's got these weird goggle type things. Hard to say. And it's got a lot of mottling effect, as well as the wounds, which the wounds are pretty good. I'm not going to say that they're in the same kind of class as, say, Ghoulish Productions. When they put wounds and gore on, they add this glistening veneer, which really makes you go, oh god, that looks painful. And yet, these do look very livid, very nasty indeed. I mean, he's been chopped up a fair bit. So this guy obviously picked the wrong, you know, home to invade. Little slit up the back there. There's no actual markings or brands on him. On the inside, you've just got a little tag saying 100% polyester, made in China. Beware of coronavirus. Oh no, I've done it again, haven't I?
read these things first.
And it does look like a very sort of slim fit mask as well, which I know I've got this big shaggy mane of hair and these kind of John Wayne saddlebags, but my head is actually very small. So if I was going to wear masks, I find that most of them just, they dwarf me once they're on, you know. One size fits all, though, it says here. So let's have a little look anyway. Let's take some of this. I love these, you know, these bags. These kind of little airbag things. Now, there are some frayed stitches because these zip, you know, the embroidery behind it is actually genuinely stitched in. So, you know, you could be pedantic and say, oh, I'll be snipping those loose threads off. Why? You know, look at him. He's meant to be a mess. One eye hole's completely gouged down there, which looks really good, to be honest. I do like that. So why would you bother with those little threads? But I know some people would. Before I put it on, I'll show you that these zips do work. There you go. But they don't open to anything. It's embroidery behind there. As you can see inside, they are sealed with very thin material. So you could rip that. But, you know, why would you want to do that? So let's zip him back up again. Because he's coming out with these wisecracks all the time. You know, can't stand these jerk-offs who come to the bar spouting, you know, their bullshit. But yeah, so let's put it on. Now, as I say, I've got this electrifying lion's mane here, but we'll try and tuck that in. Going in. Ooh. Knock. Guess who? Do you like scary movies? I like Suspiria. Ooh, that is pretty nasty. Although it's coming across quite dark, the way it looks to me on the lens right there, they are very, very red. Thick, deep red. Deep red in Suspiria. That's name drop two Dario Argento movies there. Yeah.
What?
Yeah, folks, I'm quite enamored by this. Even though it does have this ghastly sort of, you know, visage. I mean, it's the stuff of nightmares, that. If you see that looming out of the shadows, you're not going to think, hey, come in, I'll make you some toast. You're just not going to do it, are you? And although it's very definitely derivative of Buttonface, it is, it's got to be. I've got another mask which is very similar to this and obviously very similar to Buttonface. And it's termed as like an evil scarecrow. And he has, off-kilter, haphazardly applied buttons for eyes. So one's higher than the other, and although it's clearly derived from Buttonface, it's its own fantastic creation as well, and I love that mask, you know, and it's not like a big well-known brand either. And this one's just sort of, who made it? What's behind it? Who cares? It's great. And you could pretty much wear that if you were going to wear this, not for any home invasions, of course. For Halloween or some kind of horror show, pageant, whatever, party, you could wear that with anything. You know, you could go with the scarecrow look, obviously, you know, that's kind of a look that it seems to have going on. But you could wear it like Deckard does, as Buttonface, it might be with a suit on. You could wear it with a jacket, anything, you could wear that with anything. Yeah, it's just, you know, it's the fashion that never dies. Zipperman, you know, you're a man of the ages. The look that never fades, never goes out of style. But I do love that, it's weird, this sort of, I would go with steampunk, there's almost like a gas mask type quality to it, you know, but with these very small eyepieces. And I do love the horrible gouging there. It's almost like Jack Goodman from American Wealth in London, played by Griffin Dunn. The horrible rips that have done down his face. I've shown you the mask of that, known as Theatre Jack, made by Trick or Treat Studios. Great mask of his final appearance in that movie. But I'd love to see one of his first appearance when he visits David in hospital. David! He just comes out of the blue and he's all happy and he has that little bit of waggly flesh, which was a mistake that Rick Baker couldn't fix up in time for the filming. It came loose and yet it's become legendary now and steals the show. This little flap of bloody latex. But I'd love to see a mask of that. And this, you know, the rips and wounds here do come close to that kind of style. But look at that. It does look nasty, doesn't it? I love this, you know, sort of the angle of this. As I said many times, I don't like masks or creatures to be completely symmetrical. If they throw them off balance, it adds so much more of a dimension to it. It's kind of creepier, which is exemplified by this guy with his big slanty zipper mouth. Okay, you've got one dead center here, I know, but you know, the eyes are all skew-iff. It is pinched and twisted. I'm just a bit surprised about the nostrils, like the way the nose is ripped into there. Like, if it's a sack, why would you have nostrils? You know what I mean? You put holes there, I know. But that's not the way it looks. It looks like they are nostrils on the nose. I don't know, who cares? It just is what it is. There's a fair bit of shading and mottling, which you're not picking up too well there, but there's a lot of it, sort of damage and scuff marks, which only add a nice big crater here, a few dimples and depressions. But as I say, these rips and gouges, the blood is thick, it's dark, very red, you know, it's looks good. It could perhaps be shinier. I've got sunlight streaming through there, which I'm trying to obliterate with positioning of curtains, but you know, I'm just trying to see. Oh, it does. Yeah, they do shine, they do glisten a fair bit. You're not getting that on there, I know. But that is a really good mask. And I forgot how much it was. I always do this. Mainly because over there, which you can't see, is another mask which arrived just a few minutes before I started filming this. I was waiting for that to turn up before I started filming. And I'm going to show you that one later. Maybe today, maybe tomorrow. And that's a good one too. And it does follow on with this sort of theme. But you guys will know that one. But yeah, I think that's a really good mask. I love the fact that, it doesn't come down the back of the neck. You don't need it to. It's like a balaclava. It's cinched in, it's tight. You know, it's very strange. The whole zipper effect. You know, is that some kind of fetish thing? I don't know. Or do I? Am I just being deliberately vague about this? So you've got Home Invasion, you've got Purge, you've got a touch of Button Face here, and you've got a weird sort of fetish, sexually, erotically violent, charged nightmare figure. And that's what it is. But yeah. I do like the gauze effect on that. Very soft, very, you know. It's still quite secure in there, so it's not going to like suddenly ping off. Let's try and show you the inside of how they've done that. So it's quite a big area, you know, that's been stitched on there. And it is good, you know, the striations and contours. There's some good depth to that. It does have that look and feel of something that's been pulled in, that's been stretched. So those contours feel, you know, genuine and authentic. It's quite a ghastly, visage, isn't it? And as I say, if you've got a big head, you might have a problem. It does say one size fits all, but hey, you know, we've all heard that before, have we not? So, bottoms up. But yeah, That's a great mask. Very cheap, an unknown label. Probably it's derivative. It's definitely been done on purpose to mimic and then slightly alter the look of Buttonface. But either way, that's a marvellous mask in its own right. And to my knowledge, I don't think you can get the Buttonface mask. Someone out there will let me know, but I know you can get a few masks from Nightbreed, but I don't think I've seen the Buttonface mask itself. But yeah. Oh god. Yeah, it's good, isn't it? I love the mottling sort of shotgun pellet effect you've got here. And a splash down. You know, and it's got quite a good level of latex. It's quite thick. It's not the thickest, obviously, but it's not your flimsy crap either. You know, it's got a fair bit of substance going on here. Yeah, folks, I'm impressed with this. Let's seat it on this one for a second. See how well it holds up. Yeah, don't drink it all at once. Oh, that's gone the wrong way. Let's go that way. As you can see, it's hanging there. It's quite thin. It's like when you're watching some badly transferred movie on disc and it's been squeezed, you know? But once your mush is in there, it's pretty beefy. I'm impressed, folks. Good paint job, good sculpt. This is all very nice. As I say, it's a couple of loose stitches there. They're not loose, they're just frayed. But I'd keep them. If you've got a mask like that, I think that would only add to it, really. I know some people are going, oh, God, be snipping that off right away. Nah. And it is an unusual thing with the zips, and the zips that actually work. Quite like that. If you wanted to remove the material on the inside, you know, the backing piece, so that you could slip your tongue out, why would you want to do that? I don't know, but maybe you would. Obviously, you could do that so the zip would wear. Don't get your tongue caught in the zip, though. Jesus. And I tell you what, that's one of the reasons why I wear kilts and I don't wear jeans or trousers. Zips. I ain't messing with them. No more, no way. But yeah, folks, I'm impressed. By the way, what you can hear there, I'm sure you recognised it, is Cape Fear, scores to Cape Fear, which Bernard Herrmann originally did. But this version is done by, it's reorchestrated and rearranged by the great Elmer Bernstein. And this was for the Martin Scorsese remake, which is awesome. By the way, if you've only ever seen the remake of Cape Fear, gone off on a tangent here. If you've only ever seen the Robert De Niro, Nick Nolte remake of Cape Fear, do yourself a favour and watch the original, which is just as frightening, just as chilling, if not more chilling, when you consider the time it came out and the harsh taboo subject matter. Really, really recommend it. Very dark, very edgy, very suspenseful, just like the remake. Remake's a bit more pantomime, but you've got fabulously photographed, and you've got Max Cady, the incarnation that De Niro puts into Max Cady is over the top and ripe, but it's still magnificent and great fun to watch, as well as, you know, scaring the pants off you. So anyway, folks, there you go. That's Zipper Man, and that was a husky snorting just off camera over there. We're lucky that she didn't rouse. Normally when there's packaging and bags around, she'd be snuffling around trying to, you know, investigate and devour. So, folks, that's it. That was a quick video on this, because I've got the other video to do on the other mask in a wee while. So, folks, in the meantime, and indeed the in-between time, please do be safe, be happy, be careful, be kind to one another. You know, don't invade anyone's home, don't mess with their zips, just Just give people their space. And I'm going to see you all later. I'm just going to zip off that way now, if you don't mind.